Hello, welcome back. This is a core flow video. So it is like yoga and Pilates mixed together. We're gonna do some core work. We're gonna do some flows. It is a great thing to do before another type of workout or just to kind of energize you throughout your day. You don't need any props and we'll start standing. So bringing your feet underneath your hips, stand tall, palms forward. This is your mountain pose. We'll close the eyes, take a few breaths. Rounding down into your heels, all 10 toes. Soften your knees, pull the core in, think belly button towards spine, ribs give spine a big hug, shoulders down your back, neck nice and long, face soft, crown of the head really tall. This is your neutral position. When we're on our backs, you want to find this as well. Take one more breath here to stand up a little bit taller. Exhale, open your eyes. Good, inhale, arms sweep up overhead, interlace your fingers, release index and thumb, and then find a side bend over to the right so you can look up under left. Inhale, back through center, exhale, over to the left, look up under the right. Inhale, back through center, find a gentle back bend, gaze lifts, hips press forward, but core stays really strong, so try not to let the ribs open up, take a breath there. Exhale, stand tall, beautiful. Hands release, fingertips to the ceiling, we're just gonna march the knees up. And then down, switch sides. Moving really slow. You really think about plugging your shoulders down your back. Think bottom ribs come close to top of hips. Yes, and you are peeling your foot up off the floor to find that march. Good. Slowly start to turn your march until you are facing the short edge of your mat if you weren't already. We'll do one more each side. And then your right knee lifts and you hold it. Start to hinge forward, find a warrior three, string your right leg back. Ooh, finding your balance, core stays engaged. Come on back up, find your march. And then find a figure four, cross your ankle over your thigh, hands come back, sit your bum. Beautiful, take a breath here. Back up to your march, we'll do that one more time. Find your warrior three, finding your balance today. Come back up, find your march. Figure four, bum comes back, hands come to heart. And then just stand tall, switch sides. Lift the left knee up, find your march, find your balance. String the left foot back, warrior three, hinge over your right hip, lengthen everything else. Come back up to your march. Find your figure four, hips come back, hands come to heart. Pause for a moment. Good, back up to your march, one more like that. Bringing back, warrior three. Lift on up, march. Good, figure four. We're gonna meet in a chair pose. Just bring your left foot beside your right, bum stays low, arms come up. Inhale, exhale, fold. Fold over your thighs, draw off your head. Inhale, find a halfway lift. Exhale, plant your palms, step back, find a high plank. Good, so pause here, or knees can come down, elbows can come down, make it a version of plank that works for you today. We're just gonna hold for a moment. Energizing through the full body, take a breath in. Exhale, hips up and back, find a downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Good, three-legged dog, right leg lifts. Inhale, hips stay square. Exhale, knee towards nose, round through the spine, see if you can actually touch knee to nose, and then come back up. Super like that. Exhale in. Inhale up. Exhale in. Inhale up. Exhale in and then pause. See if you can draw your knee over towards your right elbow and then your left elbow. Back towards your nose. And then step your foot in between your hands. Evolved lunge, right hand up towards the ceiling. Take a breath here, long neck. Back into your downward facing. Right hand down, right foot back. Three-legged left leg lifts up, inhale. Exhale, knee to towards nose. Inhale up. Exhale to nose. Inhale up. Exhale to nose. Last one, hold in at your nose. Find your left elbow, find your right elbow, find your nose, and then step through revolved lunge, left arm to the ceiling. Breathe. Come back into your plank and then back into your downward facing. We'll take a quick child's pose, knees wide, hips back, pause here.
Rock your elbows, give your wrists a little circle. Notice if right in your wrist crease was starting to bother you. The rest of our planks, our flows, our chaturangas today, I want you to try to push more into the knuckles of your hands and your finger pads. Take some pressure out of your wrist crease. All right, so take a few breaths here. Really. We're gonna be up in all fours. So find your tabletop.
Hands come down under your shoulders. Knees wiggle underneath your hips. Pause for a moment. If you wanna do a cat-cow, you are more than welcome to. And we're gonna tuck our toes, float your knees, hold here. All right, so notice that my hips didn't come really high and my back is not arched. Neutral spine, knees about 2 inches off your mat. Push the floor down, spread the shoulder blades out. We're gonna walk up and down your mat. If you have a yoga block, I challenge you to bring it to your low back and don't let it fall to either side. All right, so everything stays really low. You just take little tiny steps to the top of your mat and then to the back of your mat. All right, staying really, really still. If you don't have something to put on your back, imagine something is there, your water bottle, something you don't want to spill. You are controlling your movement. The next time you come back to the center of your mat, just hold. Pause for a moment. Squeeze your low belly up and in. Take a breath. Exhale, lower the knees down. Beautiful. Point through the toes. We're going to extend your left leg long behind you. Pause. Reach your right arm in front of you. Pause. Notice if your back arched, your ribs flared. Tuck them in. Keep your foot and your hand the same height as your shoulders, your hips. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, knee towards elbow. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, knee to elbow. I want you to move really slow here, like you're moving through something really sticky, so that on the way in, you can really find that core activation. We have one more. Pause everything long. Bend your back knee. Bring the knee and the arm out to the side. And then come back to square. Good, we're gonna do that a few times. So rotating everything out to the side and then coming back, but trying not to let your shoulders, your hips shift side to side. All right, you are in control here, as always, in my classes. All right, so what wants to happen here is you might want to stick your bum out to the side. If that's happening, the right hand can stay down. Just move your leg. And your knee does not have to be high. Anywhere you can keep the hips pretty level to the floor. All right, you got about two more like that. The next time your knee come out to the side, hold. And then come back out to square. Right hand plants down, tuck your right toes, hover your right knee, hold here. Pull up through the belly, and then meet in your three-legged dog, straighten both legs, hips come high, take a breath. Good, knee comes in towards nose, step that foot through, find a high lunge, arms come up overhead. Cactus the elbows, find a nice big heart opener, lengthen out through your core, big breath in. Good, frame your front foot, hands come down. Find a pyramid, straighten both legs, lengthen. Beautiful, step forward, find a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, we'll move through a flow. If you jump back, land in chaturanga. If you're stepping back, come to your high plank, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward. And exhale, downward. Good, pause here, take a breath. And then come high on the toes, lower the knees. Find your tabletop again. Brace through your core. Find that really long spine. And then find your other side. Right leg reaches back. Left arm reaches long. Hold. Check in with your core. Ribs like to open. Belly likes to drop. Bum likes to pop. Don't worry about it. This happens to everybody. But see if you can really find containment through your core. Keep your neutral spine. Foot and hand are both at hip and shoulder height. Inhale, everything lengthens. Exhale, knee towards elbow. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, knee to elbow. All right, keep moving like that. And please move slow. I know I'm a broken record when I say that, but there's so many movements that we do in Pilates and yoga that if you do them fast, you won't feel anything. You won't feel stronger, you won't see results. So I really want you to move mindfully, okay? what I see so much of here is this. We're swinging. It maybe looks pretty. Nothing's happening other than maybe injuring your lower back over time. All right, so you're staying really lifted through the core, strong. Nothing is moving other than your limbs. You've got about two more. Pull up out of your right shoulder. Amazing. The next time everything lengthens long, we hold. Bend your right leg. Right knee comes out to the side, left arm to the side, and then come back through center. Good, so keep moving like that. You can definitely bring your left hand down. If your right wrist is bugging you a lot, come down onto both forearms. You can also come onto right forearm, left hand plants like a push-up. And then take a peek back at your left hip. It's probably dancing to the left. Can you stack your knee right on top of your hip? Don't let it come out to the side. All right, left obliques are gonna be working hard here to keep that alignment. That's what I want you to focus on. We are still moving really slow. You can think exhale as everything comes to the side, inhale as everything squares off. Bring your awareness back to your ribs, lower ribs. Connect to hip bones, belly button up to spine. Somebody could step in the middle of your back and your spine would be so strong, nothing would happen. You would support their body weight. All right, almost there. We've got two more. All right, the next time your knee comes beside you, hold, pull up away from the floor. Hold, hold, hold for three, for two, and then come back to square. Lower your left hand down, tuck your left knees, hover your left, tuck your left toes, hover your left knee, hold here, and then find your three-legged dog. Amazing work, inhale here. Exhale, knee towards nose. Step the foot through, find your high lunge, arms reach up overhead. Ooh, hold. Cactus the elbows, lift your gaze, big breath in. Exhale, find your pyramid, hands down. Scoot your back foot down until your heel drops. Inhale there, exhale, fold. Good, step forward, find a forward fold. Inhale, half lift here. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back, high plank, move through your flow, pull me back in your downward facing dog. Hold for a breath. Good, coming back into your three-legged, your left leg is gonna lift towards the ceiling. Exhale, knee towards same elbow, opposite elbow, and then extend your left leg long. This is your fallen triangle. Both hands down to start, hips high, and then come into your side plank. Hold, maybe you lift this left leg straight or bent. Hold for a breath. Come back into your plank, step your left foot through. Amazing. We're coming back into our warrior three. Lift everything up. Hold here. Brace through your core, lengthen everything. Slowly come up to stand. All right, knee lifts. Find your eagle legs, right leg crosses over left. Hook that foot if you can. Right arm sweeps underneath right. Find opposite palms or opposite shoulders. Inhale, fingertips come high. Exhale, we're gonna crunch. Elbows towards knees. Woo, try to keep your balance. Inhale, come up. Two more, exhale, crunch. Squeeze everything into center. Come on up. One more, exhale, crunch. Inhale up. Keep your legs bent, just unwind everything. Both feet plant, arms reach overhead. Find your chair pose. Good, squeeze everything in, core as well. We're gonna slowly lower onto your seat. So keep bending your knees, try to keep your heels down. Find your boat pose. Once your bum comes down, arms reach forward, legs come up, shins parallel or legs straight. Just hold. Good, we're gonna take a breath upright in your boat pose. Exhale, come into your low boat. Inhale, high boat. Exhale, low boat. One more, inhale, high boat. Exhale, low boat. Come back up, cross your ankles, plant your palms, move through your flow. Moving with your breath, come back into your downward facing. Good, pause. On your inhale, right leg lifts up, three-legged. Exhale, knee towards same elbow. Opposite elbow. Straighten the leg, fall in triangle. Hands down. And then left hand lifts. Stay here or float your right leg straight or bent. Hold. Back into your plank. Step your foot through. Beautiful. Come on up into your warrior three. Everything floats. Lengthen the body. Core in, shoulders down. Breath in. Breath out to stand. Find your eagle legs. And then left arm under right. Really tall in the spine here, low on the hips. Take an inhale, fingertips get higher. Exhale, crunch forward, elbows towards knees. Two more like that, inhale, lift. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, lift. Exhale, crunch. Come on back to your eagle and then find your chair. Feet plant, arms unwind, hips low. Pause here. Slowly lower onto your bum. Find your boat pose, legs lift. Good, hold here. Chest nice and bright, squeeze inner thighs. You got three times to low boat. Exhale, low boat. Inhale, high. Exhale, low. Inhale, high. One more, exhale, low. Inhale, high. Cross your ankles, plant your palms, step back, move through your flow. Amazing, amazing work. Back to your downward facing. Pause for a breath. All right, we're gonna meet on your back. If you have a jump through, come high on your toes, look in between your hands. You're gonna jump, cross your ankles. If you don't, you're gonna bring one knee forward and the other. We get to lie on our back. All right, coming all the way onto your back, can you lengthen your body really long? Arms overhead, toes point. Inhale, get long. Exhale, soften. One more like that. Inhale, long. Side out on your exhale. Beautiful. All right, hug your knees in towards your chest. Give your low back, your belly a little massage. Good, find stillness. Right knee stays in, left foot plants. Right leg extends to the ceiling. Find an angle that works. Knee is slightly bent, toes are pointed. Right leg stays where it is. Left leg is going to reach long to a hover. Does not have to be super low. I would actually prefer that it's a 45 or higher to keep your spine in this neutral position. All right, arms are gonna come overhead. They're just gonna stay, and you're really slowly gonna scissor your legs. All right, trying to keep your pelvis neutral so there's no tilting or tucking. And as always, we're moving slow, but lots of options. Your legs can be bent. You can alternate a toe tap. Arms can be down by your sides. You can march instead. Long as you're in control of your breath, you're moving slow, mindfully, and you are feeling that burn build in your lower abs. All right, option here to reach your arms forward instead. Hold an ab curl as you scissor the legs. Palms to the ceiling, your gaze can come towards your knees. Chest nice and bright. We have about four more switches here. Good, last one. Come back onto your back, head comes down. All right, finding your eagle legs again. Starting with your left leg on top of your right. You can hook the feet or anything you did on the floor. Maybe your left leg is just in front of your right. Arms are gonna come to eagle arms as well. Left arm underneath right, find opposite palm or opposite shoulder. It's gonna look exactly the same, but now you get to lie on your back. Inhale, lengthen everything. Exhale, curl in knees and elbows touch. If you wanna twist this, your elbows are gonna come to the left side of your legs. All right, if that feels like too crunchy in your hips, like you don't have enough mobility to move, just ditch that sort of wraparound. Knees and elbows can stay together. You can crunch and extend, or you can find that twist. All right, so listen to your body. If you need support for your head to crunch, hands can come behind the head. If you do not like having the feet lifted because of any hip flexor tension, you can leave the feet down. You can crunch, you can twist. Make this your own. You've got about 10 more seconds on this side, and then we're gonna pulse. Last five, four, three, two, hold it up. I'm going to reach my arms long, little pulses of the upper body up towards your knees for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax the head down, drop your feet, windshield wiper the knees, one time each side, more if you need it. And then we'll come to side two. You're gonna bring your legs back up. This time, right leg crosses over left, hook your feet, or just bring the shins side by side. Right arm comes underneath left, hold opposite palms. Take a breath in here, everything extends. Exhale, elbows towards knees, little ab curl. And then change whatever you need. Head can stay down, any of the limbs can unwind. You can find that little twist if you want elbows to come to the right side of your legs. All right, try to do what you did the same thing on side one, but if that doesn't feel good on side two, then you can definitely change things up. Just keep moving nice and slow with your breath. You've got this. On that inhale, we are lengthening everything away from center as much as possible. So you've got as big of a range of motion as possible. It's not just from here to here. I don't want you to move just like 2 inches. Try to make this big. All right, you've got about 15 more seconds there. Keep moving big. This is your time to harness your breath. Big inhale as everything reaches long. Exhale, squeeze in, lift higher. This is your last 5. Then we find those pulses. 4, 3, 2, come to the top. Hold, unwind your arms. Little pulses with the upper body. Squeeze inner thighs together for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let everything go. Head down, windshield wiper knees one side to side. Amazing work, team. Bring your knees back through center. We're gonna come up into one bridge, any version you'd like. If you've got a block, you can put it under your hips for restorative. Come into a regular bridge with me or a wheel if that's in your practice. In your regular bridge, you can pretty much touch your ankles with your hands. Feet are hip distance. You peel your hips up. Pause at the top. You can wiggle your shoulders underneath you, maybe interlace your hands. Try to keep your gaze straight up at your ceiling. Back of the neck is super long. Imagine someone's in front of you pulling your knees away from you. Lengthen the tops of your hips, your quads. 2 big breaths. And then wiggle yourself back down, flat on your back. We'll come into legs up the wall, hips planted, heels to the ceiling, arms come out to a cactus shape. Try to let everything relax here. So knees soft, hips soft. If you are near a wall, you can literally do legs up the wall, bum comes really close to the wall, heels can just rest. Honestly, you could stop the video here, hang out here for as long as you want. Especially if you're ever feeling any low back tension, that is a nice way to come back to neutral, kind of just reset, hang out for as long as you want. If you want a happy baby from your legs up the wall, knees come towards armpits, hands come towards your feet. You can just kind of rock side to side like a happy baby would. Flowing down through your breath. Good. Taking as long as you want in your happy baby. I honestly feel like I get into a trance in here and I could stay here forever. So do whatever you need. And then when you're done, hug your knees in towards your chest. You can rock up and down your spine. We'll meet in a comfortable seated position. So you can cross your legs or come onto your shins. We'll just sit up really tall. Let's take an inhale, grow tall. Exhale, let's close the eyes. Allowing your breath to come back to a natural flow in and out. Giving yourself this 1 minute of stillness before you get off your mat. Let all that good energy you just built in your body really sink in. So you can take it with you, share it with those off your mat. If finding stillness in the body is challenging today, I want you to focus on something with your breath. can count your breath. You can draw a shape with your breath. Find something that connects with you and allows you to stay present in this moment. On your next exhale, empty out the breath completely. On your inhale, start to trace the first half of a circle. You're drawing a really big hula hoop above your body. On your exhale, complete tracing that circle all the way back to where you started. Continuing to trace this circle with your mind as you breathe halfway in, and then finish it on your way out. Every time you take a new breath, can you make that circle a little bit bigger? Take longer to finish it. Expanding through your breath. We'll do one more like that. Big breath in. Big breath out. Beautiful. Allow your breath to come back to a natural flow in and out. Let's bring our hands to heart center to seal our practice. On an inhale, fill up with so much gratitude for everything your body just did. On an exhale, let go of anything you no longer need. One more like that. Inhale, fill up, feel good. Exhale, release what you don't need. Amazing. Thank you so much for moving with me today. See you next time.